Hello everybody. Today I'm going to talk to you about Plato's theory of ideas and mimetic art. Plato's view of art is bound up with what is called his theory of ideas. Ideas, he says in his book, The Republic, are the ultimate reality. Things are conceived as ideas before they take practical shape. I'll give you an example. Take the example of a horse. So in your idea or in your mind, this is conceived. You'll have lots of ideas about the horse. So the horse is nothing more than a concrete embodiment of its image in idea. The idea of everything, therefore, is its origin pattern, and the thing itself, its copy. As the copy ever falls short of the original, once removed from reality. So you see, you can see that our idea of the horse is an image. But you know, when it comes to the world of senses, or when it comes down, the horse, it manifests itself in various forms. The same way, art is also twice removed from reality. Ideas, according to him in The Republic, ideas are the ultimate reality. Things are conceived as ideas before they take practical shape. We will explain with respect to the chair. The carpenter's chair is the result of the idea of chair in his mind. So this should be the carpenter's idea of a chair. Now this chair is fashioned out in this way. So things are conceived as ideas before they take practical shape. Carpenter's chair is the result of the idea of the chair in his mind. The chair is once removed from reality. Now when a painter paints this, it is an imitation of the carpenter's chair. So it is twice removed from reality. Thus the poet takes man away from reality rather than towards it. Thus, the artist deals in an illusion. So, this is what Plato says. Now, the same thing in literature or in painting or in sculpture. The first literature is in words, painting is in colors, and sculpture is in stone. All these merely copies the copy, and hence it is twice removed from reality. The priority of the perfect form and doubt of the imperfect manifestation of it in ideas as found imitated in art has remained one of the key thoughts and a dominant issue in Western philosophy. Plato's schema, as things themselves are regarded imperfect, copies of the ideas from which they spring, their reproduction in art, are considered more imperfect still. They take men away from reality rather than towards it. At best, they are but partial images of it. That it had charmed and allured people, he readily admitted. But this made it all the more dangerous to the individual and society. Now, I'll explain that idea once again. So the concept of beauty, the form of beauty is in the mind. Now when that is conceived in the mind, this beauty can manifest itself in different forms. It can be a beautiful pottery, it can be a beautiful lady, it can be a beautiful scenery, it can be a beautiful flower. So these are individual beautiful entities. Now when they are picturized either in literature or in painting or as in sculpture, they are twice removed from reality, in the sense that paintings or photos or reflections or shadows or sculptures, they are all twice removed from reality. The first removed from reality are the actual entities themselves, and the photos or the paintings or literature or sculpture, they are twice removed from reality. So the concept of, so this is according to Plato, is that is literature is a second version of life, and writers are, according to him, impersonators, and the unreliability of the writer's presentation of life. So the concept of imitation or mimesis is crucial to Plato. It also determined the emphasis by which he manages to give a questionable status to literature. The first is the emphasis, which stresses that literature is a second-hand version. The second is the emphasis, which regards writers as impersonators. The third is the emphasis on the unreliability of the writer's presentation of life. In all these respects, Plato points to and challenges the aura of falsity that laid around imaginative literature. His larger target was the moral and social education of the young, in which art, especially poetry, played a questionable role. Thank you. Please do subscribe and comment, and more explanations will be given if required.